Hi, in this video, I will show you the very basics of creating video reviews. Most software in this tutorial is free, so check out the link below to see where you can grab it. The first step is obviously selecting the object to review. I'll take a movie as an example, but you may use any video material you have. Gameplay recordings, your own recordings, music videos, and so on. Then create a folder on your computer to store everything related to the project. I called mine Project with the exclamation mark. The exclamation marks make sure the folder is topmost in the folder list. Now, create a text file in that folder using any text editor you like. I called mine script.txt. Sit and watch your material and write down all timecodes of the events you want to show in your reviews. I usually add up a small description so that I could memorize the scene without having to watch it over. For viewing purposes, I use VLC player. It's a great player with many video codecs built in. It also has a nice screenshot feature, so it's easy to capture frames for stills in the review. If you are doing a tutorial or training video that requires screen capture, use Cam Studio. That's a great free application to record desktop videos. If you need screenshots, just hit the print screen button on your keyboard and paste it to a graphic editor. I personally use XNView, which is free and has a great screenshot making option that can grab mouse pointer. Save all your files to the project folder. After watching the material, use your notes to write the script. I normally use the same file. Make sure your phrases are easy to read and don't sound over the top. After your script is ready, the next step is voiceover. Yes, your commentary is the backbone of your future review. All the video and stills must be cut according to the length of your commentary. To record audio, I use Audio City. Start Audio City and press the red button to start recording. Then read your script into your microphone. Try to sound natural. There is nothing worse than clearly read commentaries without any voice acting. You may stop the recording at any time. To continue from the spot, hold Shift and click the record button. Without Shift, Audio City records a new track. After you are done, eliminate all long pauses, clicks, and other artifacts by selecting and deleting them. Now, select a few seconds of silence. Open the Noise Removal tool, click Get Noise Profile, remove your selection, open the tool again, and press OK. That will reduce hissing and other equipment-generated noises from your soundtrack. Having that done, select Compressor tool and compress the dynamic range of your audio. That will even out the volume of your voice, so it will sound more solid. Export the audio as a WAV file. Now we have to cut chunks of video according to the scenes you selected. One way to do this is Virtual Dub. That's a popular free video editing software. I transferred my DVD into a single video file for convenience. You may read it straight from the disk if you want. Open your video in Virtual Dub, browse to a few seconds before starting point, hit the Set Selection Start. Browse to the end of the scene, hit Set Selection End. Now crop the selection and save as AV. Name the file so you know what's in it. After export is completed, undo crop to selection and proceed to the new step. In the end, you have a bunch of video clips to work with. If you need YouTube video clips, install Flash Video Downloader for Firefox and use it to download video. If you want recordings of yourself in your video, save the clips from your camera to the project folder. I will also refer to them as video clips, since from editing point of view, they are just another source of video material. Now comes the last step, creating your video. You need the video processing software for this. I am afraid you have to purchase one. I personally recommend Vegas Video by Sony, as one of the most user-friendly video editors. I'll show version 11 in this tutorial, but you may purchase any version you like. For instance, version 6 runs perfectly on modern Windows 7 machines, and the price is very low compared to the newer versions. In fact, this software can do most of the functions described above, but personally, I prefer dedicated software over large media combines. Once you start Sony Vegas, browse to the project directory. If you got your video clips in Virtual Dub, just drag them to the timeline. You may also cut video pieces in Sony Vegas. Browse to the point where your scene begins, place the divider, now press S. This cuts the video in this spot. Select and delete all the video prior to the moment. Go to the ending point of the scene and press S. Now go to the next scene, press S and remove the video between ending point of the last selection and the beginning of the new one. Repeat until you get all your video cut. You get the cut video back in one piece. If your video has several audio tracks, first listen to them in solo mode and delete any unwanted languages by selecting the whole track and deleting it. Now get your audio commentary and drag it to a separate track on the timeline. Play it along with the video and fine cut the video to match your words with the same splitting technique. You may also cut your commentary and drag it along the timeline if you want to show some video without your voiceover. If you need to show a picture, cut the video, move it to the right and insert the picture. Drag it along the timeline. Video pauses are done in the same fashion. Create a screenshot of the frame you want to steal. You may use VLC player or the Vegas built-in player to create the screenshot. Just make sure the Vegas player is set to the best possible video quality. Now cut the video in the right place and insert the steal frame. Another way to do this is inserting a speed envelope and setting the speed to zero, but it's more tricky. But you have to master audio envelope. Insert an audio envelope to the original soundtrack and drag it low. Now, add points to the line in the moments when you need the original soundtrack for your review. Raise the start and ending points to get volume up in this segment. Repeat this to get muffled original soundtrack while you are commenting, and loud original soundtrack while you are silent. You're almost done. It's time to export your video. Select everything and drag it to the right so there is some space to insert title screen. Insert the title picture and sound if you have one. Now go to render and making sure loop is not selected, save the video to one of the needed formats. For online players like YouTube, 3 MB per second, Windows Media Video is enough. Wait till the process is finished and upload your video online. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Be creative and have fun!